Good evening, everyone. After that overwhelming response on how to crack group discussion, we're back here again, and this time we'll be conducting sessions on how to crack personal interview. I'm accompanied by my fellow colleague, Ms. Pushpakshi Chaudhary, and we'll be conducting this session together with Dr. Professor Ravi Chatterjee, sir. It's good to have you on the show back again.
Good to have you, sir.
So in this scenario of cutthroat competition, where a student of B school has to emphasize everything that he's done in the span of 25 years of his life in just about 30 to 40 minutes of an interview, it becomes very difficult for one to, you know, kind of sum up his life in just that time frame. So, sir, I'm going to ask you this question. I'm going to start by asking you some very basic question that a student of B school, whenever they're put in front of a personal interview sessions, they've been asked. Like, for example, one of the very basic questions is, tell me about yourself. Mm-hmm. You know, you have a very little time to talk about yourself, about whatever you've done in 25 years.
Right.
So how do you sum up and what you say and what you don't, actually?
Right. Yeah, I think this is a very, very basic question, and what most of the time we have seen is that people take this question for granted.
Correct.
And whenever the interview is supposed to happen, they may not prepare this question very well. And whatever the person has done in the past 20, 25 years, to recall everything in a structured manner and put it forward to the interviewer gets challenging. I think there are two ways of approaching this particular question. The person who has fair amount of communication skills, I think that person can initiate the interview, this particular question, by speaking himself or herself as a personality. So I can start by saying that I'm a person who takes every opportunity with stride and would like to do everything possible to do my best. I am a hardworking person, I've executed this in certain areas, and you speak about the examples, and then you get on to the education background, and then your internship, and then you speak about your email life. The person who's not very, very good in communication skills, he can probably start by saying about his family background, then about his education background, about his summer internship, and thereafter speaking about his participation in MBA, during the MBA program, and then the aim in life. Right?
Okay.
Why did I separate these two? Because when you're speaking yourself as a personality,
yes,
there is a lot that you have to think. You have to be creative.
Okay.
So unnecessarily putting yourself in a difficult situation would not make sense. So you should try something creative only when you are very, very comfortable with your delivery skills.
Alright.
Yeah.
So, and we have another question with us. So this is regarding sometimes a company asks you, a very basic question that they ask you is, why should we hire you, or why shouldn't we hire you? These sort of questions.
Yeah.
So often a student gets, he's already nervous about the questions, already about the session. So, and asking him this sort of question puts him in the back seat again. So, you know, how does one come up with a suitable answer for that employer likes your answer?
Right. Yeah. Yes, it's a tricky question to answer because the company people are trying to understand how much you know about yourself and how much of research have you done understanding about the company, the position. So a candidate needs to compare his skills and the culture, the background from where he or she is coming to what is expected there in the organization. So if the company has come up for a sales executive profile and there are certain job description which has been mentioned, a candidate needs to understand these job criteria and relate to his strengths and weaknesses and put it up in that fashion. So say for example, there is somebody required who is an analytical person, who is a very, very quick thinker, creative person. So I should be able to tell myself to be a creative person. I should be able to give some examples in order to relate to the requirement of the job.
Okay.
And that's how I can relate well, and that's how I can answer to this question.
Okay.
Right? So I have to relate to my background, my experience, my skill set, to what is required.
Alright.
Yeah.
So we've had this very unique question as well. One of the B school student that we'd interviewed before. So he asked, he came up with this question and asked me, suppose if a person, if a student has done B.Tech in his graduation, and he's being asked why did you choose to do MBA? Because you have a degree that is different from, you know, you don't really have to do MBA to get right. jobs. Just right. like right. So what should one say and what should one avoid?
I think this is very common that the engineering candidates going for a management course. There are candidates who are coming from medical background, from hotel management background. So how do they justify? I think the best way is to answer this question is by telling that you are having experience, understanding of, you know, two different areas, yes. which makes you dynamic, you know. And of course, you must have chosen the course in your graduation based on the time at that time, okay? Because that must be right at that particular time. But as you grew, as you came to a position where you're supposed to do your post-graduation, you felt that master degree should be done in management because that is what the need of the hour, you know? So how you should justify saying that because you come from an engineering background or a medical background or a hotel management background, it gives you more understanding, more knowledge, and with the managerial skills, you can do a much better job in that particular industry.
Industry.
Okay. So you have a broader information, broader knowledge.
One common question candidate face is salary negotiation. Is salary negotiation is good or bad, or right. they should do this negotiation or not?
I think salary negotiation is justifiable from a candidate who has certain years of experience, or that candidate has done something really great during his or her MBA time, and that person is putting it forward. Because you see, when a company is coming for hiring you, they already have a very clear understanding that for this particular position, they will be giving you this kind of salary. So if a candidate is negotiating on the salary that has been already offered or has been already informed to the candidates at the time of presentation, I think the candidate has to be really good, right? So as a fresher, I think the best way to answer to this question is that as per the industry norms, as per the company policy, you know, right?
And one more question is, sir, they ask you, tell something that is not in your CV and justify that thing. Like, for example, if a candidate telling me I'm a quick learner, right. they tell you to justify that. So right. how can that candidate justify it?
What happens is, in a resume, in a CV, we write down our achievements, our experience in a bullet kind of format, you know, time to time format. That is, in this company I did this, this is what I learned. But nowhere I get to narrate how did I do that? How did I reach there? What did I do different? You know? So that we generally cover in our covering letter, you know. But if somebody is asking you this question, what is not there in the resume, you tell us that, then you speak what you're supposed to write in your covering letter. You tell that how did you go about it? How did you reach that position from where you took up that job? You know, what was your approach? What was your thought? You know, what motivated you? And that's how I believe a candidate should answer that question.
When interview starts, when an interviewer asks about, introduce yourself, and when they introduce yourself, they come about their internship. Right. So is the job role should change according to the job profile that the company is coming and interviewing?
Okay, so you mean to say that, does that matter that where I have done my internship, is it the same to what the job profile is offered? I really don't think so, because say for example, I want to go for a HR role, and while my internship I was heavily loaded with recruitment work, and the company that I'm supposed to join, they are giving me a job role which is related to grievance handling or say something to do with training module creation. So I think that should not matter too much because you have worked in the similar lines. But yes, of course, if that is in the same lines, it definitely adds on to your experience and putting forward your case.
So I now have this very basic, one of the basic questions again. But the most talked about question is when you're signing the bonds. Mm-hmm. It's certain times a company comes to you and tells you that are you comfortable by signing this bond for 5 years? You know, future is uncertain. You don't know what's going to happen next.
Right.
And suppose, for example, if the company is a startup company, now eventually, in some years from now, you find growth going and you've got to get opportunities from a bigger company. So it becomes difficult because you signed a bond here.
Right.
So what should one say to that, and what should one avoid?
Mm.
Is my question to you.
I think I would like to answer to this question by keeping two sections to it. One may be the approach, and second is your answer. Okay. The clarity should be there with us. Bond is something that is not accepted in Indian scenario, because the Indian government doesn't permit bonded labors. You know, so when you're signing a bond, you become bonded labor. So that philosophy is not here. So nobody can take you to the court saying that you have abided by the policy. The second is, you need to understand why the company would like you to sign the bond. A company must be spending a lot of money in training you, you know. So the company wants that you should spend that amount of time with them so that the company can get back what they have spent on you, okay? So approach is very, very important. We fell in love, and when we fall in love, we think of getting married, right? So why are we bringing the legal issues?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That gives us the confidence. That gives us that that positive feeling that yes, something is right. Similarly, the company also wants that you should associate with the company with that kind of understanding, with that kind of seriousness. Okay. And if the company is showing that kind of seriousness towards you, you should be rather happy.
Right.
You know, because you should feel that the company is giving me that kind of importance.
Yes.
Because of which the company is asking you to sign a bond. So, and sadly, the reverse is generally felt by the candidates.
Yes.
So I think this is how the candidate should approach it, and the candidate should be very, very okay signing the bond. And say if the bond is for say 5 years and you have to leave in between, and you have a genuine reason, the company will let you go. I really don't think there will be any company which will hold you back.
Okay.
Yes.
So you are.
One another common question, that where do you see yourself after 5 years?
Yeah.
So many candidates feel that it's a very tough question they face in their PM.
Right.
So I really want to know this answer, that what is beyond that?
If you want to answer it in a very nice manner, very, very easy manner, which may not give you too much of score, they will say, yeah, I would like to see myself as a senior manager. Okay, easiest answer. But that may not help you to get the grade. The company people are trying to understand how futuristic you are, you know, how calculative you are. If you're saying that you will be there in next 5 years as senior manager, how you will reach there? What is your approach? You know, so in the first year, what are you going to do? Second year, what are you going to do? So is that clarity with you? You know, so a candidate should approach by saying that, say in the first year, I join your organization, I get to understand the basics, how the company functions, what is the reporting tree, you know, how the departments are arranged. In the second year, as I've got the clarity of the basic working, I will try to, you know, groom myself better in the area, right, in the job responsibility. By the time I reach third year, I would be already there in a senior position, you know, understanding the basics and everything. I will try to build up relationship with the other people and enhance, personal relations. Fourth year, as I've already built up that kind of relationship, I would like to increase my skills. So I'll go for some training and all that. By the time I reach the fifth year, I already have that kind of understanding, that kind of bonding, that kind of training required to be there as a senior manager. So this is how you deduce and prove that by next 5 years you will be there.
So you have to take it step by step, basically. So
yeah.
You have to define how you're going to get there. It's just not about saying that I see myself as a manager or something.
Yeah. So it's definitely not an easy question.
It's a tough question. Good question. All right. So there is this question that we have the people often ask. Tell me about your weaknesses. Now, talking about your weaknesses can leave a negative impression on the employer, on the one who's taking your interview.
Mm-hmm.
So how should, and one has to be honest also. So how should one go about saying the right thing so that it leaves a right impression on you. Because you can't say that you're not punctual
right.
and everything. It leaves a negative this thing.
Right.
So how, what should one do about it?
Weakness is asked in order to understand how much you know yourself.
Yes.
Because a candidate needs to, you know, keep looking within himself or herself
yes.
and keep improving. That's how you go ahead, you know. So understanding your weakness is a crucial part. And of course, you should not speak about a very, very critical weakness.
Yes,
like you said about punctuality
yes,
or short-tempered.
Yes.
So you should find something that is, you know, okay. Say for example, you are a workaholic. So you say that I keep working and I forget, sometimes it affects my health. Or you say that I am not very good in time management. So what happens is, if I prioritize something that is very important, I get stuck with it.
Yes.
Until the time I don't finish it, I don't move on to something else.
Yes.
But even to these weaknesses, you should be able to give an answer that what is the solution you have found.
Right.
So it's very important that how you're delivering this answer. So say for example, somebody has asked me about my weakness. I would say that's I'm a workaholic person, which sometimes troubles you know, me having a proper you know, timetable for my food, and which makes me suffer as far as my health is concerned. So what I've done is I've started making a timetable, and based on the importance of the work, I carry it on so that I'm able to balance it. And I think more or less I've found a solution for it.
That's fair enough, sir. Actually, so we have this another question with us. This question is about when an interviewer asks you who's your role model.
Yes.
So what sort of an answer do you give to that? Who's your role model?
Generally, I find candidates speaking about their parents, their teachers as their role model, but I think that may not work very well in an interview setup. They should be able to find a role model from the company in which they would like to join.
Right.
So that is going to give the complete insight that they have you know, explored the company, they have found the leaders in that company, and they have got inspired by them.
Right.
So he or she is absolutely justified applying for that job, you know, and that would make real sense.
Right.
So I think a person should do a little bit of homework and find out people who have really contributed to the you know, growth of that company.
Right.
So we all know that communication is really important, and but some in like some candidates, particularly the HR candidate, face this problem that whenever interviewer asks them about what are their strengths, if they tell that their strength is communication, so the interviewer asks them why we need to go for marketing, because communication is more important in marketing.
Right.
So what should that candidate answer?
To justify any field, there are many skills which are required. Of course, communication is important, and communication is as important in marketing as in HR, you know. So if a candidate is going for HR and he or she is putting forward that his or her strength is communication skills, I think there is no problems. If the candidate has communication skills, it's very, very good, because as an HR, you would have to handle so many issues, the grievance per se. So if you don't have good communication skills, how are you going to prove the point to the people? So of course, it's also about your liking, you know. So the candidate can speak about his liking, his approach towards life, and what exactly that person wants to do in his her life.
Yes.
You know, how you see your progression in your career path. So it is a personal choice that you're making, and you must have already done so much of work previously in order to justify to what you are applying for.
So they say first impression is the last impression. So, you know, how does one maintain that impression? Because right from the time you enter the hall to the time you're sitting down or you've been told to sit down, you've been judged. You're already halfway there,
right.
Whether he's interested in talking to you or whether he's not.
Right.
So what should one say to that? How should one behave accordingly?
Well, I think we all are very, very clear about the basic etiquettes and the grooming. Like, you know, I should be well combed, I should not have any facial hair, my sideburns should not be
low
below my hair
lobe. Yes.
So, you know, and I should be dressing up appropriately, in the sense that I would be wearing a light shade shirt and a dark shade trouser with leather shoes. You know, and for girls, I believe there is no any strict foundation to what is formal and what is informal. But yes, I think you know, a smart kurti or a western shirt and trousers that will also do. The most important thing is your hairstyle. You know, it should not cover your face, or it should not fall on your forehead. We should not wear a very strong perfume. You know, we should not wear too many accessories. This is all about how you should carry yourself. You should be confident when you're walking in. Handshake, you know, which is very, very important. It should be firm. And if you have those sweaty palms, make sure that you are carrying your handkerchief and you wipe it off before you shake hand.
Yes.
It's also very crucial to understand that handshake should come from the interviewer's side, and we should not be the person, you know, putting forward the handshake.
Right.
So we should wait on, you know, till the time that person is not putting forward a hand to handshake, we should not. Till the time the person is not asking us to sit down, we should not sit down. And we should know that the table which is there in front of him, it is his, and I'm not supposed to keep my portfolio file on that. I'm supposed to keep my portfolio file with me, and I should be able to answer. You know, I should not make too many hand gestures, but I should be able to justify and use my hand appropriately. I should not be looking, you know, too many places. I should be able to look towards that person and answer to the questions.
So this was very important. So whatever we've got out of this session, this has been very informative for us. So my friend, my colleague, fellow colleague, would like to sum up this whole session.
So guys, from this session, we get to know this, that be prepared, get to know yourself good about the company you're going for the interview, and be confident, all the best. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for having me, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks.